Why now is because Democrats and feminists got it wrong in 1998. When allegations of serial sexual misconduct by Bill Clinton coalesced into concrete, provable, and thus finally admitted behavior, the left rallied to Bill Clinton's defense. The same feminist movement that would have gone nuclear if Bill Clinton happened to be a Republican instead stood by Clinton's side. Prominent feminists like Gloria Steinem wrote op-ed pieces defending Clinton, while Bill's own wife set about savagely attacking women like Juanita Broderick, who very credibly accused Clinton of rape. Bill Clinton not only survived in political office, he went on to become a veritable rock star of the political world. For its part, the feminist movement, which in reality is liberalism by a different label, began to condemn centuries of civil custom as it pertains to how gentlemen should treat ladies. To hold a door for a lady, or to stand when she excuses herself from or returns to the table, or to offer one's jacket to a lady to ward off a chill, was dismissed by feminists as condescending, demeaning, and patriarchal. And thus we arrive nearly two decades later to learn that men, freed from the societal sanctions the gentleman who would dare mistreat a lady once feared, will gravitate toward the brutish behavior to which males of every species default. Depending on the set of one's attitude, a woman is either God's earthly and precious vessel of life, deserving of male respect, protection, and veneration, or she's a sexual object from which men may obtain selfish pleasure. We now realize that too many attitudes were set by Bill Clinton being given a pass in 1998. That's my word. What's yours? Go to youtellmetexas.com and you tell me. And follow me on Twitter at Paul Gleiser.